I'll say this is one I do not agree with. I keep running. Oh, look at 32. What we got here on number 32? The term Moor was applied to dark skin, brown skin, and reddish brown skin people. Reddish, as our good brother Chief has mentioned, and brown are the same color. All right, we got A1 and Chief back in. What's good, A1? What's happening?
Yo, tell him. Right. Hey, Lotus.
Yeah.
Tell him. Hold up. That's number what? Number 32. Read number 32 again. Read number 32 for the Aborigines that hate Ahanu the Moor, or Hanu El, or AKA a Tonsonous one.
Let me hold on.
You want me to read it for you?
The term
Moor was applied to any dark skin, brown skin, or reddish brown skin people who were not only indigenous to Europe, but West and North Africa. It's saying, but in black Indians of the Western Hemisphere was dubbed with this title. So if all Moors is from North Africa, why would they dub it to people here? And just to make sure, if you study etymology, there was no fucking North Africa in 7-Eleven when you claim the Moors went into Europe. That's why I keep telling people, don't research. They get caught up in all this shit they hear other people say, and they don't do no research for themselves. And then when you hear other people say, you still want to argue it. This man wrote this book right here, P. Kanyon or whatever, you know what I'm saying? And he's a researcher. And I've been telling people this shit for years, but everybody come at me. If I say anything about anything, everybody hate, like, and that's what it is, man, because people don't research. You listen to other people and you don't research. They've been telling you it was a synonym for Negro or applied to any dark-skinned person. It ain't got nothing to do with MSTA or Drew Ali, and I've been telling people that for years. But go ahead. I'm going to mute my mic, man. Go ahead.
That's it. So you're going to love number 33 then. Oh, man. You already know. I mean, I'm this is new to me. I like when I'm reading. Indigenous Black Celtics, or as many say, Celtics. Indigenous Black Britons. Indigenous Black Portuguese and Indigenous Black Spaniards, all also known as Moors, had a long time knowledge of indigenous people in the Western Hemisphere. These Moors were well informed of the different customs, traditions, and languages of the natives of the Western Hemisphere. These dark-skinned Europeans, Moors, were used as buffers by pale-skinned Europeans to help colonize the New World. These indigenous Black Europeans, aka Moors, not only solicited the New World to pale-skinned Europeans, but also waged war on indigenous people of the Western Hemisphere, aka Indians. And this is a conflict that happened that I also happen to know about.
And I ain't got no, now I'm not telling you that that didn't happen. I told you, but that don't apply for Abe. That don't apply for all of them. You know what I'm saying? You had, even over there in Europe, think about it like this, bro. You got to understand this, bro. You got to study Spain to understand the connection over here. If you don't study Spain, you don't understand the connection over here. You understand what I'm saying? You can look at the structures and you can look at the antiquity that they built in Spain or Andalusia, right? Now, you ask yourself, if they from North Africa, you cannot find some of this stuff in North Africa. Now, I ain't going to front. Morocco got some old stuff there. They got universities and stuff there as well. But Morocco just became state in 1937.
That's right.
So where was Morocco at before then? And I'm not saying it was here, but where was it at?
And even the education system was what? Less than 100 years before that. That was established by the Alliance Israelite University in Morocco. Yeah,
you have to look at Lemuria, man, and that's the connection that you probably will find people being called Moor or Moor. You know what I'm saying? That's the connection right there, man. You know, it's kind of drop got a video, man. When you show the cartoon of little boy Moor and the little boy Moor, the Egyptian and the and the Atlanteans. We know the Atlanteans was black. We know the Egyptians was so-called. Well, no, we know the Atlanteans was copper color, brownish, or whatever you want to call it. The same thing with the Egyptians, and the same thing. The little boy Mu got dreadlocks in his head, and he's from Lemuria. And this is a damn cartoon, and they calling him Mu. You understand what I'm saying? So you got to research. You guys can't take everything you hear people say, man, and then flip and bounce it and then take it. And then, you know, listen, bro, I'm being arrowed to death, man. You go look in the comments on my last video, bro. I'm being arrowed to death over my statement. But the funny thing is this, though, Lotus. Go to my videos. I've been talking about the Moors. I got Hakeem Bey in one of my first videos. So if you've been following me, you already know what it is. I ain't never denied nothing. I stand firm with what I say. Other people want to debate me and have these personal issues with me instead of saying, look, man, the work you've done helping me or whatever, if it's helping you or if it's entertainment, even if it's helping you get through your day. Look at what people do and look and judge people from that. Don't judge people from what you hear other people saying and get caught all in your films. Like, oh, don't fuck with A1 no more. Don't fuck with me then. I'm not going to debate. I'm not going to lose no sleep over it. So my bad, bro. I didn't mean to chop it up, but go ahead. But I agree with what you're saying. I'm never going to disagree with that. You have Maurice schools that actually helped Columbus get here. You know what I'm saying? So I'm
yeah, not, people over here that help too.
Oh, he brought with him Arabic and Hebrew speaking, whatever you want to call them. You understand what I'm saying? I'm not never going to deny that. I know you had Maurice schools that was over there at Andalusia that fucking converted, that knew about over here because they was doing trades, they was bringing stuff. And like I tell you, study the Moors in Europe. You study the Moors in Europe, you'll see what did they claim they brought over there to Spain. Two things you find in America: cotton and sugarcane. You find that. You Google but research it. If you look in Van Sertima book, The Last Golden Age of the Moors. If you read Jose Parmenta Bay work, you'll see a lot of stuff. Also, Wayne Chandler got works on the Moors or whatever, as well as I forgot the name, Great Britain. I'm trying to think of her name. It's gonna come to me in a minute. But you have to read. And once you start seeing what they took on, you're like, wait, they had to be coming back and forth to the Americas because it's too much stuff coming. It's too much stuff you find coming from the Americas that you find over there in Spain. Lemons, oranges, all that shit is indigenous to Florida. Don't let nobody tell you lemons came from the Americas, man. You know what I'm saying? So you have to really look and see. You have to study the Americas first from outside of this tribal shit. See, everybody's so caught up in this tribal shit to where that's hell. That's stopping them from really doing the real research and saying, well, look, man, look at what's Mexico City called? What's the name of what's Mexico City? The island, huh?
It's just some money for mother.
Mexico City was on a peninsula. It looked like a man-made island like Dubai. But it had pyramids and everything in it. You think regular Indians built that? You think these Indians that's living in these damn teepees and shit, you think they had something to do with that?
Hell no. Nah.
All right, then. So they wasn't even what it's so funny that they don't call the Mayans or the Incas Indians. They don't call the Mayans Indians. They only reserve that for these. They only reserve that for the primitive people. You don't never hear them call. And now, like I said, I got videos talking about Indians and everything. But when you start looking like, wait a minute, man, there's castles here, man, the universities. So these people that you got running around here living in these TPs. Abraham, son. Oh, my God. The fuck is this? No doubt. But yeah, you got these people living in these damn TPs and shit. Like, and I'm not trying to be funny, but we look at this Mongoloid history and think it's our history. No, that's not our history. That's their history. And you don't even see most of the Southeast Indians running around here with feathers in their head. You know, we only see the mongoloids out there doing that shit. So I just, I'm sorry, but I didn't mean to mess the build up though, but that's a great build though with the 103 facts, man. You gonna finish it up?